Time now to get to the weekly options report with Alan Uckman of Agora Financial. He always gives us a trade of the day. But before we get to that, Alan, wow.
Market melt up.
About 500 points plus
in the Dow.
So
there was a big Dow move. Now, last week we had an unkind unwind, and then yesterday we had a market melt up. So let's see if we can get some follow through. Last week, it was just seemed like some profit taking, some forced profit taking. And I think some buyers stepped in one more time.
Well, you have some Dow components amongst your trades, including McDonald's.
Yeah, McDonald's. We took off half a position last week before the market fell. Made 50% on the first half. We have a 160 call. Now it goes off the board on Friday. So it's in the money. The market closed at 164 yesterday. Let's see if we can get just a little bit more of a bump in the next couple days.
Facebook's another name a lot of people are watching.
Facebook broke down, went below 160, but it has bounced back. It's right to that 160 level. So let's see if it can get better here. We had a real quick rebound in the tech sector yesterday. Let's see if it can follow through.
And then amongst your commodity trades, Cleveland Cliffs.
Yeah, Cleveland Cliffs holding up fine. It's at about break even. So this is a perfect example of why we trade options. We're able to ride through the ups and, well, the downs and then the ups of the markets. That's an October option, goes off the board on Friday. So we're about break even. We'll see how we can salvage that and make a little bit of money.
A lot of swings in the market. And then finally, Sunoco.
Sunoco, an oil play there. Now that's a November option, so that's got plenty of time. And Sunoco did pop back yesterday, back above the 30 level. So if we hit 30.50 again, that's a recent high, then that target's 32.50, and that should give us some nice profit. We'll keep an eye on that.
And in this week's trade, your WPI trade trigger is looking at PBR. Is
it sticking symbol? In the same sector. We're looking at PBR, Petro Brazil. It's a November 14 call. Now, this is a stock that was at 17 in May and dropped to 9 in June. So that big $8 drop, if it can get back to that 17 level, it's got a big upside V recovery target at 25. We've got more than a month of time here, so let's see if that can make a quick move for us.
You give yourself some time on that one. You never know.
There you go.
Let's take a look at the trading floor takeaways for today.
Number one, test and reject. The major markets, the Dow, the NASDAQ, and the S&P, all went down to their 200-day moving average and then came right back above it. So that's a very positive sign.
And then FFF.
Finally, fundamentals on Friday. So you notice how the markets turned. All the big banks announced over the last couple days, and combined five banks made $30 billion in profits for the quarter. So that's a very optimistic sign that the fundamentals will carry this market.
And I know you're watching the vol fall.
Yeah, that's key for me, because we saw the VIX explosion. We rallied up to 29, so a pretty lofty level as the fear factor goes, but it's still significantly lower than where it was in February when we hit 50. Now, yesterday, we were at 17 at the close, so that's a 40% drop in a couple days. We have seen this before, where volatility spikes and gets beaten back down one more time, and then the market goes higher.
Well, thanks so much for coming on the show, and have a great trading day.
Thank you.
Check out businessfirstam.com to find out where to see our entire show. And don't forget to like, follow, and share Business First AM.